problems because we have only 1 hour. Only 1 hour. 203 problems. Very difficult problems. Yeah. One more. Okay. Today we will talk about basic function.
Wait.
Good.
当你遇到一个很复杂的问题，抽丝剥茧。
Rotate can drop this term, just zero, zero. So this is one only. And phi is finite at gamma equals zero. Gamma equals zero. That is here. It's finite at gamma equals zero. And pi. Gamma equals pi. Okay? So in this case, Q will diverge. Drop this term. And because m is zero, and because of zero pi is finite, so we know v will become integer. So we can express as ln. Before that, we don't know the value of v. But now, we can determine the value of v. V is not always integer. Not always. I will show you a case. The formal method to solve for AL and BL is to match the boundary condition at R equals R prime. Okay? That will be done in section 3.9. And here we will obtain AL and BL by using the fact that we change. We already know potential should be here. We use this property. And for a point source Q equals 4 pi epsilon 0. This point source is 4 pi epsilon 0. So the potential is here. And we know R smaller inside, R outside is here. Okay, but still not enough information for us to determine AL and BL. So let's simplify the problem again. Let's consider 21 F gamma R minus R prime absolute value. If R is smaller than R prime, you should write here. If R is greater than R prime, just write here. Okay? By comparison, R prime 1 over R, 1 minus R prime over R. This is smaller than 1. Smaller than 1. Okay? So you can write into this one and this one. And this one write into O. And this one becomes this one. No big deal. And this one is moved to here, the same. Okay? And these two can be used to compare with the previous case. And so we know AL just equals to this one. BL equals to AL is inside, so AL equals to this one. BL just equals to this one. We know AL, we know PL. We just use the special case. Special case is the observer is also on the z-axis. On the z-axis, source is here. Observer can be here, can be here. Can be here, okay. So on the z-axis, we have infinite points. And all the points and here correct. So many points is correct. Just like the boundary condition. We match the boundary condition. So this will be a correct solution. So we use a special case to determine the coefficient, just like the master of image. The master of image, we use the same techniques. Griffiths just assume there is a cube here, and there is a cube prime here, and this S prime. And we match the boundary condition, And then we can determine all the coefficients. Just two special cases. And Jackson give you a more general case. Okay, just two special cases. Just like on the z-axis. Same techniques. Okay, so 1 over x minus x prime equals to this one, inside, outside. We are not sure this is correct or not. If we want to test, we should use Laplace Poisson's equation to double check. We just, and a special case is correct. But it's not general. We are not 100% sure it's correct or not. Not 100% sure about that. Okay, but it's okay. This expression can be divided into two conditions. Okay? For R prime is greater, R is smaller. R prime is smaller. Can we further simplify the expression? Yeah, we can do that. Two expressions. With two equations in one, two in one. But we have to pay the price. The price is R smaller, R greater means if R smaller is the smaller of R and R prime. R greater is the larger of R and R prime. Okay? Smaller and larger means the just compare these two values. And this one is larger, this one is smaller. Okay, then you can just substitute to this one. Jackson preferred this notation. He said form, which holds, true when the unit point charge is at any arbitrary point, just like this one. This case, just consider z-axis. Start with the z-axis and consider from this case. An angle is gamma. Later on, this angle gamma, we know gamma is related to theta prime, theta, phi, phi prime. Okay, so we can change cosine gamma to spherical harmonics. Charge group, slightly different, okay? distribution, charge distribution. That's actually not that easy, but also not very difficult. You need to practice. Homework, we give you some chance to practice. To write the charge distribution. You can write this one into Cartesian coordinate, spherical coordinate, cylindrical coordinates. Which one is more convenient? Of course, here we are talking about spherical coordinates. So we will express in terms of spherical coordinates. So we just write it into delta theta minus alpha. Alpha is the angle from the axis to the ring. And delta R minus C. C is from here to here. That's C. You can write into this hole. If you don't like, you can write into just consider C cosine alpha. In terms of cylindrical coordinate, Z minus C cosine alpha. C cosine alpha is here. That's the Z position. Rho minus A. No. Rho minus A is here. Okay. Why we don't use cylindrical coordinate? Because we will have two rho, and you will be confused. Okay. Too much simple. Charge distribution in terms of spherical coordinates. And we don't know the coefficient, okay? But we know total charge is Q. So we perform the Wallen integration. R squared sine theta, dr d theta, d phi. And this one, only when theta equals R. So that will become sine alpha. And only when R equals C squared. And this one, phi will give us 2 pi. And coefficient K is still the same. So K can be determined. Okay? So rho is here. Q over 2 pi C squared sine alpha. To delta function. Okay? If you don't mind, just move here to here. That's okay. The relation is here. We talked about this issue in chapter 1, page 12. If you don't believe, you can check your lecture note. Chapter 1, page 12. Delta m of x can be right into here, or prime. And we just here move it back. This expression can be right into this form. This form is here. This expression is here. Okay? Why we do that? just chart ring, infinite space, so no boundary. Therefore, we can use the simplest green function. This one. Infinite space. We can use the simplest green function. Okay? So potential can be right into this form. No contribution from the surface. Because surface is very, very far away. So lucky. Green's theorem tells us that in principle we should consider another term. But this one, very, very far away. So we don't have to consider that one. And rho x is here. So this one is right into here. So this term is here. This term is here. Just substitute everything into here. Q 2 pi c squared. Q 2 pi c squared. 4 pi cancels 4 pi. And we have epsilon 0 here. Summation. L from 0 to infinity. M from minus L to L. Okay. Here. 1 over 2 L plus 1. And here. R greater. Maybe not. Up to here. R 这次课可以跟我讲。 still have 30 minutes left. I would like to emphasize that I do not expect you to remember all the mathematical details. Okay, that's not my purpose. Because the mathematical detail, yeah, you have the ability to remember the mathematical detail for a week, maybe 2 weeks. But after that, you will be easily forget if you don't use. If you use over and over again, then you will be familiar with this one. However, not everyone is a theoretical physics. Not everyone. Okay, maybe you will become a general manager or something. So it's almost impossible to remember all the mathematical details. So what is easy to remember? Physics, the properties. Okay, starts from the physics. Because physics is much more easy to remember, and you will leave an impression in your mind. Okay. Let's move on to Laplace equation in cylindrical coordinates. That will be Bessel function. So Laplace equation. Maybe I should tell you my purpose first. My purpose is use this Laplace equation to find a complete function set, and then we can express this one into cylindrical coordinate Bessel function. That's our purpose. Okay. Express this one into Bessel function. To do that, we should start with this one. And it's here, separate into this one. And we can use the separation of variable, rho phi z. Rho phi and z. Okay, rho phi z, and substitute this one to here. You can separate them. Separation of variable is good for some symmetry problems. Not all the case, but luckily for the UR students, you can almost always separate them. Okay, when you are students, what happened if we cannot separate them? What happened if we cannot separate them? Yeah, we know. Computer. For example, some software. Yesterday, a general manager from a company, he told me he just purchased a software to calculate this one. He spent about 10 million New Taiwan dollars. 1,000万台币。我就跟他讲，我在清华只要10万台币哦。就我们这边有买授权。 We are authorized, but for educational purpose, just 100,000 for educational purpose, but for business purpose. study graduate, this study class competition, and he is the general manager and president of 5 companies. And another example is Dr. Chen Hanyu. He is the general manager of Hongshuo Qikong. And Bessel function a lot in our spherical case. Spherical case is too simple. And spherical case is difficult to manufacture. So we prefer a cylindrical structure or something, some kind of cylinder. So we use Bessel function much, much more than the geometric polynomial or spherical harmonics in our lab. Okay. So Bessel function, and we can write Hankel function again into the linear combination of these two. These two. Okay. So it looks like cosine, sine. Looks like. Okay. So you have many expression. Not many. Bessel function, Newman function, Hankel function, IK. Okay? Too much. You can skip this one. Hankel function. Still too much. You can just erase this part. Okay, but anyway, Bessel function, Newman function, is the fundamental of cylindrical coordinates. Let's have a look at this figure. That's the Bessel function. That's the Newman function. Bessel function, just like sinusoidal wave, but it's up and down and smaller and smaller and smaller. Bessel function starts from 1, some starts from 0, and smaller and smaller and smaller. That's the Bessel function. Similar to Lagrange polynomial. Newman function, up and down. But lucky, see, diverge. Good news, we like diverge very much. Because once it diverge, drop this term. Diverge. However, if you deal with some kind of problem, this we cannot drop. However, if you deal with a problem like this one, if you see a problem consists of outer cylinder and inner cylinder, then you need to consider Newman function. But here, once again, if no inner conductor, you can draw the Newman function because it will diverge. Non-zero here. Phi equals V rho phi. That's given. I just give you the potential. Normally, I will give you a V0, you will consider infinite number of terms. Let me think. Okay, so the solution, Laplace equation, general solution, separated into three parts. And it's z dependence. Let's check z dependence first. A plus b, and phi equals 0, and z equals 0. Bottom plane. So b will be equals to minus a. So z dependent is exponential kz minus exponential minus kz. So we can write into a sinh kz. That's the z dependence. Okay, next one is not finished yet. We still have one more information. Phi equals 0 and rho equals a. That's on the side wall of the cylinder. So ZnKa equals 0. ZnKa equals 0. K becomes K and N. What? N, I know. What is N here? N can be 1, 2, 3. roots. You can, the first root here, and boundary is zero. Or you can do that, the second, but squeeze here. So squeeze to here, zero. You have multiple solutions. Multiple solutions, just like a fixed end sine. So some first one, second, and third. Similar idea. So you will have multiple root, not just one. So we use K and N. So therefore, K is not arbitrary, but it's quantized. Becomes a quantized value. Because of the boundary condition, K and N will become quantized. Okay, quantized. Boundary condition can allow us to quantize the value. So, X and N is the nth root of, say, N, 0. So now, you can write into here, Bessel function, n equals 0 to infinity, sum n equals 1 to infinity, say n, k and n. K and n is here. Sinh, k and n, z. Wow, k and n. And sine, or sine. It's not finished. We just write the general form, but we still need to determine A and N and B and N. How to do that? Also, orthogonality. Once again, we use the orthogonality. This is the orthogonality. Once again, it looks like connected delta. Connected delta. Don't worry, you don't have to remember, because you cannot remember this equation. And say M, K, M, N is complete. So, two expressions, completeness and orthogonality. Use these two properties and you can determine the coefficient. And we are going to use this one to determine the coefficient A, M, N, and B, M, N. So the result will be the boundary condition, the last boundary, z equals f, row 5. Okay? And we will use this one and this one to determine all the coefficients. Okay. Just we do not determine at this moment because we do not give you the value. We do not give you the value. I just show you how to do that. The technique is quite similar as cylindrical coordinates. Quite similar to the cylindrical coordinates. Spherical harmonics, Bessel function, Lagrange polynomial. Quite similar. And you can compare the coefficient without calculating. We now substitute everything here. up here because we still have time. Maybe 15 minutes. Thank you. 太大也没有，多大也没有。千万眼睛都不眨一下，然后。
每年都可以做到一次鸡蛋，然后之后就或者他会换成。
我们的确是有戏哦，每年捐1000万，不用眨眼。你可以看最外面那个李毅吧，不过他1000万分给很多个单位。啊！我在跟他讨论事情的时候，我就看他副校长带队去跟他，我们想要盖什么东西，我们要盖游泳池，我们要盖校友体育馆，我们要盖什么东西，需要多少钱？他还是有噪音，噪了很多次。承受很大的压力。我今年有一个朋友，今年3月的时候。